Evening, greetings. Welcome to Fright Night. The title of tonight's turkey is Imbecility Eating. Now here is your host, that master of the macabre, the epitome of evil, oh sinister bad to crawl across the face of the earth. Seymour! Good evening, Frenchies. Good evening, Wayne. That was very nice. However, you read part of it wrong. The title of our film tonight is not Imbecility Deleted. The title of our film is an imbecility, so I had it deleted from your intro.
But what is the title of your movie?
I hardly think that's important, Wayne. After all, I'm what the Fringes tune in to see. The movies are just incidental to the show, just something to fill in between my brilliant, though exhausting, performance.
Yes, more sure. Oh, no. Hey, guys. Look at this.
Well, Fringes, it's just you and me. I don't care that my movie tonight is for slime people, and you don't care either, do you? Do you? I know that, you idiot, but you're supposed to read it, not them. Most of the Frenchies can't read anyway. Why aren't you reading? I've been struck dumb. Wayne, you've struck me as dumb as long as I've known you. What's this? I've got a frog in my throat. Huh? You got a frog? Let me open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open it. That's a frog, all right. Well, Wayne, have you tried talking over your voice? After all, I've been talking over your voice for years. A little joke there, Wayne. All right, Wayne. Now, I've hired you as an anonymous voiceover, and an anonymous voiceover who can't talk is totally useless. Now, you can either get your voice back immediately, or don't expect a paycheck this week.
You can't do that, Seymour. I'm in the union.
Aha! But you're also talking. I've caught you gold-bricking again. What do you think of that? Wayne, watch your language. You can't write that on a television show. This is a family show. Wayne, come back here, Wayne, you get right, roll the film, quick, Wayne, get back in here, I want to talk to you. After 15 weeks of the worst bananas ever put on film, KHJ has finally given us a worthwhile movie. The Incredible Shrinking Man is a science fiction classic, although you'd never know it by this first segment. Scott Carey is out boating with his wife when a little sea mist drifts by and he ends up by starting to shrink. Now, if that isn't ridiculous, I don't know what is. I mean, really. A little fog never hurt anyone. Obviously, his shirt's just stretching the wash. The doctor at the Institute simply forgot to get enlargements of his x-rays and just jumped to conclusions. After all, fog does not shrink people. Well, it just doesn't.
Seymour!
What is it?
Seymour!
What is it, Wayne? Can't you see I'm busy?
But Seymour, you're getting smaller. You're shrinking.
Don't be silly, Wayne. I'm not shrinking. And take off those idiotic elevator boots.
I'm not wearing elevator boots.
Well, if you're wearing high heels, Wayne, I don't want to hear about it.
No, Seymour, it's you. You're getting smaller.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, this is terrible.
Well, I'll say, instead of the Incredible Shrinking Man, you'll be the Incredible Stinking Man.
Wayne, Wayne, if I get my tiny hands on you, I'll wring your fat neck. Wayne, bend over so I can reach you. Wayne!
Complete with a personalized message and signed by Seymour... What's his name? That's right, Fringies, this swell visor can be yours by sending $2... plus 50 cents for postage, tax, and handling in check or money order only to Seymour, KHJ TV, 5515 Melrose, Hollywood 90038. And to go with that swell visor, how about this neat Seymour t-shirt? Available in adult sizes. Small, medium, large, and extra large. For $3 plus 50 cents for postage, tax, and handling. In check or money order only, please. Or either the visor for $2 plus 50 cents, or the t-shirt for $3 plus 50 cents, send your check or money order to Seymour, KHJ-TV, 5515 Melrose, Hollywood 90038. Do it now.